Today, let's take a look at a common Excel lookup question. How to look up values to the left column in Excel. And sometimes it's phrased differently as Excel left lookup or left VLOOKUP. Let's take a look at a quick method that helps us do a left lookup in Excel. To check for availability of XLOOKUP, take a look at the description of this video. A quick method is to use Excel's XLOOKUP function. So here we have a list of employee names and we want to get their IDs back. On a separate tab called Master, we have the complete list of our employees with the employee ID, department, and the employee name. Now notice that the employee ID, so what we're looking for, is on the left-hand side of our lookup range. No problem for XLOOKUP. So just start typing XLOOKUP. When you see it here, press Tab to select it. First argument is the lookup value. So what are we looking for? We're looking for the employee name. Next argument is the lookup array. So what's the range where we can find the employee name on? Well, it's sitting in the master tab. It's right here. So press Control Shift down to select the whole range. Next argument is the return array. So what do we want to get back? We want to get their IDs back, which is sitting right here. Now notice the other arguments of XLOOKUP here are in square brackets. This means they're optional. And we're going to cover them in more detail in the next video. In this case, we're done with our formula, close bracket, and press enter. So Gary Miller has ID number 4. Let's just double check. That's Gary Miller, ID 4. Now, before we pull this down, we have to make sure that we have fixed the correct ranges. So we don't want our lookup array and our return array to shift while we pull down the formula. So let's just highlight this and press F4 to fix everything. And that's it. Let's just send this down. And these are the employee IDs for these employees. We just did a left lookup using the new XLOOKUP function.
So that's how you can do a lookup to the left in Excel. If you like this video, do give it a thumbs up. Now in the next video, I'm going to take you through the other features of the new and improved XLOOKUP function. For example, how to deal with errors like the hash NA errors, how to do two-way lookups, look for approximate matches, and more. Until then, take a look at the other videos on the channel and subscribe if you haven't subscribed already.